boys. Well, here's the third part. I've finished it for him. As you can see, I've distressed it now as well. You can't really pick this up. I'm not the best at photography, so sometimes it's nice to show some stuff in photography and some stuff. Hope you can see this, where I've brushed it with my finger and stuff, and it's give the leaves a lot more life. You know, as you would normally see outside, I suppose. It's not really picking it up, but there we are. Hopefully when Brian gets it, he'll be able to see. It looks totally different in here as well, the colour. If you can see there, when you look at it in person with the eyes, you can actually see the very, very faint strokes where I've feathered it out, and so that you can see the leaves are a little bit more like... Anyway, and your knife, Brian. It's the same with these. When you take pictures of these, because of the shininess and the glint, it's very, very difficult. So, yeah, there's the knife. And all I've got to do now is make your dangler as requested, mate. You know, I've popped you a solid brass D-ring on. And... fits just nice, it'll break in lovely, that. Good bit of use, and that'll break in lovely. There we go, there's that noise. Okay, nice and deep. Hope you like this, Brian, mate. You know, I've done a lot more than I would normally. I've left yours a bit chunkier on the back as well than I would normally do, and I've done that on purpose for a reason. Just to aid with the overall rustic look that I wanted to give this for you. Because I know you love being outdoors so much. It was hard for me, really, to do this, you know, because obviously I like the pristine stuff. But, you know, because I know you love being out in the woods so much, that's... the look and the way I wanted this to be. I didn't want everything perfect and uniform, which is hard for me, as you lot know, because of the way I am with having, you know, with the OCD and stuff. But you know, I've got there, you know, I didn't want all these all crazy uniform, and you know, I wanted it a bit messy and higgledy-piggledy, and you know, just like how the floor is in the forest. You know, it's not all uniform and stuff, so, you know, I've, you know, like these bits here and stuff. I just wanted this really, really rustic, you know, used and rustic. So, hope I've achieved that. I hope you can sort of get what I was trying to achieve with this. You know, for an outdoorsman and somebody who loves the forests and stuff, you know, hopefully that, you know, you guys are a real mad into that, as I love being out there myself, and will appreciate this type of rusticness. You know, so that's what I was trying to get for him, with the distressing, and I heated up parts, and, you know, and moulded certain areas, and, you know, I did little bits more with this, and made it a bit deeper and stuff, just to bring that out a bit, and, you know, I left some in and took some out of here, and you know, as you do, I just didn't want, you know, there's some stuff, you know, like little touches and stuff that I just wanted to do in peace and quiet. So yeah, okay, when I could think, if you know what I mean. So there we go, hope you like that, bro. It's just a simple dangler for me to do now with a couple of poppers. I might put your sand browns on, I don't know yet. Okay guys, hope you like that. Hope you like it, Brian. You deserve it, mate. So, I'm here. You know, I made sure the line was a bit off on purpose, which done me head in, but I did it for a reason. I then went back and I've put marks in and stuff just to give it more of that rustic look. You see? It just all adds to that real rustic, rough, and, you know... That's what I wanted to achieve, you know, like oak leaves and stuff on the floor, You know, all these lines wouldn't be really parallel, would they, on the floor and stuff like that, you know. So I did like this extra line up here that, you know, is it, instead of it following here completely, it veers off into there a bit, look. You know, it's not perfectly uniform. Because that's how it'd be, wouldn't it, on the forest floor and stuff, so. Hope you like that, mate. Take care. Hope you've enjoyed the series of this. I hope it's inspired some people to have a go. And I hope it's inspired some people to have a go. And if it's helped anybody out a little bit with the tooling, there will be other projects that I'll bring you through and I'll bring you along. Thank you for all the subscriptions, your kind words and the kind comments. I shall probably have a couple more to do before Christmas, and that'll be me then with the kids. Okay, guys, I've got the knives. I've got, I think, four orders or five with them that I've got to try and get out before Christmas, really. I'm hoping. I've got Mr. Irish's stuff I've got to get done. You know, whether it will be done before or not, there was no time limit with that, so I do thank you for that, mate. Mr. PLD, you know, I'm trying my best to push forward with yours to try and get it out before Christmas. Hope I can for you, mate. So the belts have arrived, so that's helped. They've all been heat treated and everything now, so anyway. Okay, take care, bye for now, Lee.
This is a story about a dream girl, one I've never told. This is a story about a dream girl, one that I've never told. This has been happening ever since I